Welcome back to one more video session. This is Vasant Naik from Canara Engineering College. In this video session, I am going to teach you the difference between CISC and RISC processor. Now, before explaining the difference between CISC and RISC processor, now, what is the full form of CISC and RISC? The full form of CISC is Complex Instruction Set Computing. The full form of CISC is Complex Instruction Set Computing. Complex instruction set computing, and the full form of RISC is reduced instruction set computing. Now we will see one by one what is the difference between CISC and RISC. The first point is instructions of in CISC is instructions of variable size. With respect to RISC, instruction of fixed size. Let me explain the difference between instruction of variable size. Like if you take the processor 8086. In processor 8086 contains 1 byte instruction, 2 byte instructions, 3 byte instructions, 4 byte instruction, 5 byte instruction, 6 byte instruction. You take the microcontroller 8051, which has got 1 byte instruction, 2 byte instruction, 3 byte instruction. That means instructions of variable size. But ARM is a RISC processor, ARM 7 is a RISC processor, and all the instructions here, students please note, all the instructions here are 32 bit in size. 95% of the instructions in ARM are 32 bit in size. So all the instructions are 32 bit in size, and data bus of ARM 7 is also 32 bit. That means which will guarantee that the execution of or fetching of the instructions will take exactly one clock cycle, whereas in CISC processor the fetching of the instructions take place a different clock cycle, many clock cycle based on the instruction size. That is the difference between instructions of variable size and instruction of a fixed size. Now let's see the second point. Second point is multiple fetch cycle. Let me write here multiple fetch cycle, multiple fetch cycle. Here with respect to RISC it is one fetch cycle. So as I explained here earlier, CISC instructions are in variable in size, so this leads to multiple fetch cycle. Like depending on the size of the instructions, the fetch cycles time also vary. But ARM instructions, all instructions are 32 bit, it will guarantee that all instructions can be fetched in one cycle. So that is the difference between a multiple fetch cycle and one fetch cycle. Now we'll move to the third point. Student, the third point is operation on register and memory. Operation on register and memory. But with respect to RISC, operation on registers only. Operations on registers only. You know, CISC processors are flexible processor. CISC processors are flexible in nature, which will allow operation on register and memory. For example, let me take you to the blackboard. In CISC processor, we have instructions. For example, if you take 8086, we have instruction add AX, BX. That means the value of register BX will be added to AX. We have other form of the instruction add AX, bracket 2000. This is the memory operation. That means data will be get from this location and it will be added to the register AX. That means CISC will support both registers and memory. But in ARM, all the instructions will be executed in register only. All the instructions will be executed in register only. Only two instructions will be executed in memory, that is load and store. because all the instructions are executed in register, which can guarantee that all the instructions can executed in one cycle. And anyway, you know, memory operations are slower than register. So ARM can guarantee that all the instructions can be executed in one cycle. This once again gives the impression that CISC processors are flexible. CISC processors are flexible in nature. ARM processor is rigid in nature. Of course, ARM processors are rigid in nature, but which gives a very good performance. The very good performance compared to CISC processor. ARM processor gives very good performance compared to CISC processor. Yeah, students. Now we'll move to the next point. CISC processor has got many addressing modes. As I said, CISC processor will allow operation on both memory and register. Naturally, it will have many addressing modes. But CISC processor allow operation only on register, it will have less addressing mode. That is the fourth point. And the fifth point is, CISC processor makes use of few registers. RISC processor makes use of lots of registers. Yeah, CISC processor makes use of few registers because CISC processor will allow operation on memory. But ARM is based on the RISC and it has got many registers and it will allow operation in registers only rather than memory. Only the memory operation allowed in ARM is load and store. That means if you want to execute anything, first you have to load that from memory to the register, do the execution, then copy the result, store the result back to the memory. That is the difference between load and store. That is the fifth point. Student, now we'll move to the sixth point. Sixth point is, large instruction set. Large instruction set. Here, reduced instruction set. Most of the students confused here, will get confused here. Reduced instruction set means instructions are reduced. It is not exactly so. First, we will see what is the exact difference between large instruction set and reduced instruction set. In CISC processor, which have multiple form of instruction. For example, CISC processor will allow to work on memory and work on register. That means, suppose if you take add instruction for register, add instruction for memory. If you take subtract instruction for register, subtract instruction for memory. Add with carry. Instruction for register, add with carry instruction for memory. So multiple forms of instructions for single operation. But in a RISC, all the instructions are executed in register only. So reduced instruction set. So that's why the difference. Reduced means there will be one form of instructions. But in CISC, there will be a multiple form of instructions. Student, now we'll move to the seventh point, complex instruction set. As I said, in CISC has got variable instruction size, like instruction of different size, like 1 byte, 2 byte, 3 byte, 4 byte, 5 byte, 6 byte. Based on that, and there are different form of instructions for simple operations. Based on that, the instruction set will be large and complex. Now, as the instruction set becomes large and complex, the decoding process also becomes complex in CISC. What do you mean by decoding? Decoding process, what do you mean by decoding? Normally, first the instruction is fetched from the memory. Then instruction will be analyzed what has to be done. That process is called as a decoding. And after that, instruction will be executed. So, because of the complex instruction set, naturally, decoding process will be complex. But with reference to RISC processor, the instruction sets are simple and decoding stage is also simple. And for your information, CISC processor adopt micro program control unit for decoding, which is something like software based, but our RISC processor adopt hardwired execution unit, so which is faster than micro program control unit. That is the difference between point number 8, and now we'll move to the point number 9. Point number 9 is multiple execution cycle. That is multiple and with respect to RISC one execution cycle. One execution cycle. I will explain you this one. Before that, let me note down the 10th point, the next point. Point number 10, poor pipelining. So now student, the point number 9, 10 and 11, let me explain. So here multiple execution cycle, in RISC processor one execution cycle, and poor pipelining and excellent pipelining. All these are interrelated, all these points are interrelated. Let me explain you. First of all, what is a pipelining? In the last class, I told you the pipelining means dividing the process of instruction into independent section and overlapping it. Let me repeat, dividing the process of instruction into independent section and overlap it. So both CISC processor will adopt pipelining and RISC processor will adapt pipelining, but the pipelining process of RISC is better than CISC. The answer for the question is let me write here. Normally in the processor, first the instruction will be fetched, decode and executed. In the normal processor, the instruction will be fetched, decode and executed. This process will continue. But in the pipelining processor, first instruction will be fetched, decode and executed. When the instruction will be executed, it will decode the second instruction. Same time it will fetch the third instruction. So here you can see at a time the processor works on three instructions. That is one instruction being executed, the second instruction being decoded and third instruction being fetched. Now if each instruction takes its own time, for example if the fetching takes more than one cycle, then it will affect decoding and execution. If the execution takes more than one cycle, it will affect the fetching and decoding. So we know our 8086 or CISC based processor has got variable size instruction starting from 1 byte to 6 byte. So you cannot promise exactly, you cannot guarantee exactly like all the instruction will be fetched in one cycle. It may take more than one cycle, that time it will affect the decoding, or sometimes execution will take more than one cycle which will affect the fetching. That means the whole idea of pipelining will be killed here. For example, you see, if I write the instruction like add AX comma 2000, this is the memory operation. This is the memory operations. So when the execution is taking place in the memory, how it is possible for fetching the next instruction? When one instruction is executing in the memory, how it is possible for fetching the next instruction? That is not possible here. That means the whole idea of a pipelining is killed here. But when you take ARM, the execution will take exactly one clock cycle, decoding will take exactly one clock cycle, fetching will take exactly one clock cycle. That means as long as all the instructions are executed in register side by side, fetching will take place in memory. That means execution on decoding will not interfere fetching. Fetching will take place side by side, and executing and decoding will take place side by side. That means all the instructions will be executed and decoded and fetched in one cycle. That will give very good performance. So let me take you to the once again our notes. So the ninth point is it will take multiple execution cycle, but our ARM will take one execution cycle. And as I explained, CISC processor has got poor pipelining, but RISC processor has got excellent pipelining. I can say three-stage pipelining of ARM 7 is equivalent to the six-stage pipelining of CISC processor. Finally, we can say it is CISC processor are flexible, but too much of flexibility will eat the performance. But RISC processor are rigid, but it gives faster and very good performance. So, student, this is the difference between CISC processor and RISC processor. So, it's an important question from the exam point of view. What is the difference between RISC processor and CISC processor? It's a very important question from exam point of view. So, with this, I will wind up this video. In the next video, we will study one more concept. Thank you.